Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone in between. I am Diana Clarion, the Lavender Lady. How the heck are ya? Okay, this is part two of the filming I've been doing today. Part one, you can see if you want to look at the absolute mess of cabling that I've been doing all day. You'll find a link to that somewhere up there, I think. I have no idea of how to do these links. I haven't even tried one yet, so there's something else I'm learning today. But part two is a little bit of a surprise. It's nothing no one's done before, I'm pretty sure. But it is an unboxing, because in the whole planning, such as it was, of this thing, I noticed that I was running out of space on the desk for the microphony over here, and I was thinking of perhaps, you know, making room and setting things up like a soundstage, to wit, this little guy here, which is an InnoGear microphone boom. Let's see, it's model MU-047, that's Mic Uniform 047. $20 at Amazon, $20 US. So, it wasn't all that bad as far as the price goes. You know, I hope it does pretty well as far as going into service. You know, we're gonna find out, I'll tell you that right now. What happens? Let's have a look. Okay, first of all, there is a tab that holds this thing closed. So that's pretty nice already. That's kind of secure, you know how that works. Open this puppy up. And we kind of get a flip top. Ooh, look at that. I like that. Okay, what we have is everything just nicely jammed in there. We have a little bit of something, I'm not sure what that is, keeping the windscreen nice and clean or something, you know, with the help. Let's just stick that over here. We have a pop filter, and it's nicely crushed. So we're going to see what happens with that. Oh my. Register now. Hey, yeah. Whatever the hell that does for you. Look. It's a user manual. Sure, it's all in pictures. I'm pretty damn sure. Wait, there's a word or two on here. Interesting. We'll have to see how that works. And of course, we want you back. Take 10% off your next purchase. Look, guys, I need to find out if this thing works before I do anything else, okay? All right, that goes there. Now we have some nice little, it looks like anti-static plastic. Why would that be anti-static? Because I know what's in here, and it's not CMOS. Oh my. Okay, then we have, it looks like we have a boom arm. Okay, in a bag. Keeping it clean and fresh and stuff. Now go over there for a minute. Look. And here is a C-clamp. Looking pretty good, actually. And you're going to get to see all this stuff as I screw around with it in a minute. And, okay, this appears to be hardware to hold a microphony. Certainly not the one I have, but some sort of microphony. Oh my. And oh, look at this. Teflon tape. Yeah, okay, that may come in handy, I think. I think I saw something somewhere that may need this. Okay, and then the box is pretty much empty from here. Okay, let's do some reading out and see what they have to say. And while we do that, we can also do other stuff. Okay, what do we have? We have user manual, and yeah, it's not much of anything really. Okay. We have, it's amazing when you have to take your glasses off in order to see. Yeah. It says, installation of the stand. Unscrew the clamp so that the opening is large enough to fit over the edge of your table. Let's have a look. I remember seeing a clamp. I'm reasonably sure this is the one they were talking about. Okay. Bag is secure. I'll give it that much. Let's get my buck knife going here. Yeah, all right. Yay. Okay, how's she looking? Okay, so when they say unscrew the clamp, they must mean this little guy over here until it's large enough to fit over your table. And my word, will you have a look at that. I have a feeling that not only could it fit over the table, it could fit over the entire desk. What do we have here? The opening on this, get over here. Okay, opening on this is about 2.25 inches. Okay, given that the desktop here on my graduate student desk is about 1.5 inches, and that's pretty damned hefty. This can go just about anywhere, as they say. So, okay, that's one good thing in their favor, maybe. Okay, that's another good thing in their favor. So, now we have a little something over here, and I suppose, little thumbscrew. And I suppose that the operation of this thumbscrew will become apparent shortly. Now, here's the deal. Okay, here's what I'm working with. What are you doing, little one? Little one, what are you eating? No, you do not want to eat that jump ring. For the love of St. Gulick. I love the kitty. I love the kitty. I love the kitty. I love the kitty. Yeah, all right then. Lose that baby in there, but it's in there. Sort of like there was a tomato sauce or something like that, I know. I'm not going to do this as they're saying how to do it because I don't know quite where I want this to go yet. So let's pretend that this is open enough to go wherever. And then they say, push the clamp all the way onto the table edge for maximum security. So I take it that they want the edge of the table or whatever it happens to be all the way back here. Okay, that kind of makes sense. You know, nobody, you know, I'm not surprised at all over something like that. What do we have? Okay, fasten the clamp to the desk by anti-clockwise. Ooh. Turning the handle so that it is tight against the underside of the table. Now, this is something that they would have done well to state in point number one, because if you're tightening by turning anti-clockwise, but you're not. Okay, they screwed up. Write this one down, kids. on point number three. This is a right-handed thread, not a left-handed thread as they suggest. And again, participial adverb, that's the word I'm looking for. You know, a right-handed thread, a left-handed pitcher, I'm not going to say it because GLAD will be all over me and so will the rest of the internet. Okay, so that, let's pretend that that is on the table wherever it happens to go. And notice how this is nice, you know, it's that whole thing that I first saw on a vise where you clamped it to a table. Nice little C-clamp. Okay, let's pretend that's on. Four, insert the arm into the hole at the top of the clamp and then twist the knob to tighten it once the arm direction is located. You are now ready to attach your microphone. All right, so by the arm, I take it, but they mean this guy. Right. Rubber bands. Okay, those come off. All right, here. All right, there's the top of the bag. Yay! Yay. Let's get this out of here. What do we have? Okay, we have an arm. Let's have a look at it. This must be the little piece they need by inserting the arm into the hole. Let's find out. Okay, here's our C-clamp again. And okay, there's the thumb screw. Let's open that baby up. Let's see what I'm doing. And that will go over here. Okay, so yeah, there you have this little thing. You have this little thing. But let's just tighten the thumb screw a little bit. I mean, just for the hell of it, and see how that works. Now, I'm looking at this. Okay, it's interesting. We have a thumb screw here, we have an arm here, we have an arm here. I was kind of hoping for three arms, but hey, you know, that's just the way it goes, I suppose. Okay, let's see. Let's see what the little manual says. Hmm? I guess for $20 you don't necessarily expect three arms. We'll see if it does a decent job. Okay, they have notes here on how not to install. They don't want the C-clamp angled onto the edge of whatever it is. They don't want the little hold down arm, whatever this thing is called over here. They don't want that at an angle. They want everything straight and flush. Okay, it's fine. We can do that. Okay, now we have application of the stand. All right, you can connect to the plastic mic clip. And they are saying that you can screw this little guy over here. Let's get it out of the bag. See what we can do. Okay, I'm going to look at that in a minute. Okay. So it appears that they are saying that this threaded end of the clip here can screw onto this little, whatever you want to call it. And let's see. Yeah. How do you like that? That's a pretty good job of it. Not a bad job at all. Okay, but I'm not using this. Like I said that already. And of course I dropped it on the floor. No problem! Yay. Okay, you go over there. Okay, then they tell you what to do with a shock mount, which is not included and I'm not using. The shock mount, they have this little, call it an adapter, which will screw onto here and then you can screw your shock mount on. Okay, that's fine, not a problem. It works. But what we are going to do is connecting to the Blue Yeti or to the Blue Snowball or to the Blue Yeti Nano, all not included, no kidding. This Blue Yeti cost me $114 and that's not going to be in a box with a $20 boom. No, it's not. So let's see what we've got here. Okay, we can use possibly the adapter for the Blue Yeti as well. You screw that into the mounting interface of the Blue Yeti and then you can do whatever you do. Alright, let's give it a shot. Swag of it. Take this over there. Here's the table stand that I had on there. What they're not telling you in the manual is that you're going to unscrew this. From the desk stand. Wait a minute, what did I drop? I dropped something. Oh, it must have been another. I know what it is. So, okay, I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be looking for the two things I dropped. There's one of them. How do you like that? Now I'm going to be searching around on the floor for the other one, and then I'm going to set this aside for a moment. Because I don't want to lose pieces, parts. Yeah, don't want to do that. So anybody who is considering mounting a Blue Yeti on something that requires you to remove the table stand, these guys, these little washers, if you will, fit between the table stand and the Yeti right back here. You don't want to lose those the way I did. And just a little piece of advice, that's all. Okay, back into the chair. And we will screw the hold down screws back onto the Yeti. So let's see. There we go. There's one. And the reason you have these is one side is convex, the other side is flat. I'm sorry, not convex, concave. And there is a difference. You don't absolutely have to do this for the darn thing to work, but it's just kind of nice. Such that you don't lose these things. Okay, so now you have a Yeti. Okay, this. Okay, let's look at the underside. There is a large inside thread, and it appears that, yes, you do indeed need that adapter in order to get that on the boom. Not bad, not bad, not bad. So, here comes the adapter. We're just screwing that puppy in. I want to be reasonably sure that it's on securely. Yeah, it's reasonably tight. Now, I have seen something elsewhere that indicates that it may be the case that the threads on the Yeti are a little larger than for the adapter. That's why they included the Teflon tape. Now, in my case, everything was fine. Or at least it seems fine. So, okay, now comes the joy of getting this thing screwed on without dropping it. It's a $114 mic. I don't want to drop the damn thing. I don't have $114 to replace this. Okay, we seem to be doing all right. We will see if we can mess with it one way or another. It would be nice to have the mute switch available. Okay, there is some give. Some give in the threads. So, I mean, as I'm thinking of doing, I can have the I can have the boom to my right and mess with the mute if I have to, or I can mess with it down here. Now, this isn't looking exactly like it's going to look in use, but no, we're getting there. So now we can go back and I have a feeling I know what I want to do with this thing. Let's unscrew this. Okay, it's a little unwieldy with a heavy microphone on the other end. So I'm sure that's why this little instruction thing says, put it where you want it to go before you do the microphony, but it's okay. It's okay. Now comes the fun part, where we get this over le table. If I can reach under here, all right. Okay, so it isn't going to work on this desk. it isn't gonna work on the desk because I cannot run this all the way on. And boy, am I glad that happened now and not when everything was in service. All right. Let's do this again, huh? So now, the question. Now the question becomes, where do I put this? And the other idea I have, which just might work, would be nice if it worked. Let's tighten this pretty well, so hopefully we don't lose it. You know what I'm gonna do? I know what I'm gonna do. Yeah, why don't I do the intelligent thing? And just unscrew the damn mic. Because, okay, I can now because I'm pretty sure I know the way this is going to go. Or at least I hope I know. At least I hope I'm sure. Well, being sure is one thing. Being correct is another. Okay, you're going to go on the desk. And what I'm going to do... is like so. Now this isn't the whole thing here. Keep that in mind. But at least I have this hutch. And it's great. When I built this, I wasn't thinking of this application, but it turns out that here it is. And yeah, I for those who don't know, I built this desk and hutch. Oh, for the love of St. Gluck, I think I built it 16 years ago. I think I built it in 2003. And it's served me well over the years. It really, really has. Okay, we're getting there. Yeah, we're getting there now. Okay, this is hopefully working. So I'm screwing this down, and hopefully... I can screw it down reasonably tightly. Hopefully it's not going to fall off or anything like that. Then I'll loosen this thumb screw. And let's see if this works. Let's see if we can turn this around. Now they don't tell you anything about how this thing moves or anything like that. All I know is that it's articulated here at the clamp, at the elbow, and then at the wrist. So, yeah, I can move this like so. I can move this like so. And then, okay, as far as this, okay, let's liken this to an arm. I mean, I already was. I was calling this an elbow and I was calling this a wrist. So if we liken this to an arm, the forearm isn't quite the way I want it. It's heading down, which may be exacerbated later. We're going to find out. So I'll loosen the thumb screw, turn this up, and see if we can manage... Okay, see if we can manage that. You may or may not be able to see what I'm doing. Okay, because here's what's going to happen, kids. I'm going to, when this is in use, I'm going to be sitting here. This, as Cy Strike said when he was here, so this is where the magic happens. Yeah, and this is indeed where the magic does indeed happen for whatever, good or bad magic, black or white magic, you know, go from there. So now, okay, we've got that there. We can bend the forearm to bring the whole arrangement closer to me. And it appears that, okay, we'll do it that way. And the only problem I have with this, I wish that it were possible to articulate this in the manner of an arm, where you have your arm, you can move the forearm, you can move the elbow, but you can also twist the upper arm, and the, so it would be nice if I could do that with this, but I really can't. So it's a matter of what I have to do, that sort of thing. All right, let's loosen this for a moment. We're gonna try to move that up a little bit. Weight's gonna carry it down. All right, so there's over there, there's over there. This isn't very tight. So, okay, that's to the disadvantage here. But, you know, c'est la vie, if you will. Now, if I do this, okay, it's tight enough to keep it there. So we have this arrangement here where you have the arm out and moving the forearm back over. And then we have this, and okay, our problem now is that it may or may not work well this way. We're going to have to put it into service because, okay, remember now, when you're dealing with a Yeti, this is something to remember, you do not, as I have seen some people do, point the mic at you. You do not do this because the pickups are around the circumference of the cage. So you want to be talking to the microphone like so. You want it up and down, you know, the way you see the old radio mics or the mics that Carson Letterman used to use. You know, looking like this. So that may actually work if we have the mic like so. But this is where we've got to be really, really careful now. We've got to screw this on and hope that the whole freaking thing doesn't fall apart. I would not like that if it did. And of course you're gonna say, yeah, what do you want for $20? I know. I'm not wealthy. I once was, never will I be again. I know that. I'm not necessarily complaining. I have a complaint or two in that there are some things that are a really good idea to have that I cannot afford anymore. But that's the way it is. All right, there's a problem. Okay. The twist here is too great. You cannot have this tight enough to hold this, and it's just going to drop. Question though is, how much is it dropping? Can it work from there? It's a possibility. We will have to see as this is in service. But what I'm going to want to do is to for the Addy Boot, let's put it that way. Let's set this on the threads in such a way that the pattern is facing me. The pattern on, I have this set to cardioid. So, for those who don't know about microphone patterns, a cardioid is a heart-shaped sort of thing with the mic at the interior point of the heart, and then the lobes go out and around, and you go basically like so. So you've got this semicircle, more or less. Okay, the way this mic is, the semicircle is facing me, and there's essentially no pickup from the other side. An omnidirectional pattern would have pickup everywhere. It would have, you know, 360-degree pickup. There are a couple other patterns which I don't remember, so I'll have to go look them up. Okay, so I'll put that in at one point or another. I'm just going to sit here talking because I want to see what this thing does as you screw around with it. It's just too bad that this can't fit on the table, but that's all right. It's no big deal. The other possibility that I have is to put it on the printer table. All right, what we are going to do is get a measuring device, see? And I want to see how much lip I need. It appears that I need, about an inch and a half. Can I get an inch and a half over here? Actually I can. All right then, so what I may end up doing here, and what I think I'll try now, is moving this down to the printer table. All right, so just to make it a little easier to screw with, okay, it doesn't want to be nice. Be back shortly. this is something that always comes in handy. Whether you live in a house or an apartment, whether you are boy, girl, man, woman, anything in between, you always, always, always need a decent set of tools. You never know when you will need them. So let's just grasp this little guy over here and let's do some loosening. Okay, wait, I was going the wrong way. Yeah, color me blonde, will you? Okay, then. So everything's coming off on this, which is okay. If ever I need to later, I can just get over here with the pliers and take that guy off. I don't need that right now. Okay, what I'm going to do at this point, just for the heck of it, okay, that comes off, everything's over here. We are going to try to run this onto the table. Okay, looks like we might get somewhere. Looks like. Yeah, I know my back is to you. That's unfortunate, but you know, it's the way it has to be right now. I'm working in my studio, not on a set. Okay. We are going to loosen the thumb screw. We're going to turn that around a little bit. That way. Up. I'm not altogether sure I'm thrilled with this, but if this is what $20 buys, this is what $20 buys. That's what I've got. And if this is all you've got, at least I'm going through this so you don't have to stumble across it without foreknowledge. How's that sound? Let's get this together. Getting it together. Peace and love, baby. Come on, you can do it. We are engaged. How do you like that? Is for you and to date and a thing for there. Yes. Okay, this isn't altogether bad. It's just going to be a matter of screwing around with the printer whenever I want to use it, and that's not all that often. So, I got the printer because as little as I use it, when I have to use it, I have to use it. Okay, there you go. So then, what we want to do now is work out what we may or may not have to do here. Let me go to, yeah, I know where you want me to go. You know, you tell me where to go and what I can do when I get there. Yeah, I'm just looking up twist ties here because I may or may not want to use a twist tie. Okay. We'll see how that goes. And now, remember the cable I left hanging, if you will. Oh, okay. Clarion is blonde.
Mm-hmm. Here it is.
And we have the other end of the cable that we plugged into the back plane of machine number one, way back in the first video. And this, of course, is going to get put into the arse end of the blue Yeti, like so. And then that'll drape over the knuckle. Well, not so much the knuckle, but you get my point. And for the moment, I'm just going to see if I can't wrap a I can. How do you like that? I'm going to wrap a twist tie around this thing, just for a little bit. Just to hold the cable in place. Yeah, no big deal. So what we have now, okay, is hopefully la setup. Yeah, C-E-T-T-E up. There you go. Now the question I have is that going to pick up well enough as far away as it is? Am I going to need a screen? Am I going to need a pulp filter? Those things will be decided in service. It'll be okay. Okay, it'll work. Okay then. I'm looking at that. If I have to, I can move it closer here onto the desk. Because really all I have to do is hit the power switch and on occasion screw around with stuff, and hopefully the occasion will not be all that often. So this is going to be as it is for now. I may fool around with things a little later. I'll tell you you guys about it if I do it as I do it. And the only thing I have left at this point, I suppose, is to fire it up and give it a try. So, let's see what we've got. What I can do is use a sound recorder. Sound recorder, that sounds too much like wind blows. I can use Audacity. There we go. And try some recording here, see how she goes. And from there, we just have some fun with it and see what happens. Okay! Power on! Atomic batteries to power, turbines to speed. Oh, look, I have coffee. And of course, this is going to take forever. Wait a minute. Can't wait. There we are over there. Yeah, I'm guessing this is going to take halfway to forever. So, you know, it's just something I have to deal with whenever I screw around with this thing. I'll have to play around with it someday and figure out what's happening. That's really all I have to do. Okay, I see the magic word Ubuntu. The system is running in low graphics mode. Hey! There's a way around that. Try running with default graphics. Oh my, okay. Yeah, we want that to go to machine one. That's not too bad. Fooling around with that, it's out of my way. Okay, we're getting there, we're getting there. Yay. System problem detected. Yeah, I know. Come on. You need that poo-poo. Yeah, it's a poo-poo over there. That's what it's doing. It's being a poo-poo. All right. Well, report problem, and it's going to crash while I'm reporting problem. I never said Ubuntu was perfect. It's just a lot better than wind blows, at least for my purposes. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this off and then back on. I know. Because that, one way or another, seems to write some configuration files that are necessary to get it going the next time around. Okay, over there. Hey, this is all right. This is working pretty well. I like that. You just reach, you reach. I'm not worried with crap falling off the desk over here as it was previously. The whole world isn't taken up with this. I mean, it's not that I don't like this. It's just that, you know, finding room for it was a pain in the arse. Especially if I need, you know, like, of course I need coffee space. One always needs coffee space. And then writing space is over here, and here's new stuff and things. And, you know, what can I tell you? Just waiting for this thing to fire up and we'll be all set, hopefully. Yeah, we're getting there. Yay. And here we are. Okay, let's bring up the Audacity. And, okay, there we are. We're getting there. We're getting there. And there we are. Hello. You all there? All right. Let's try recording. Okay, how's things? Oh my. Okay, so wait a minute. I'm seeing that going all the way up there, and I'm seeing that over there. Okay, it's kind of looking okay. It may or may not be okay. We're going to find out. So, okay, we are going to stop this. And, okay, file. We are going to export audio. And going to export it as test.flac.
Ding.
Okay, where is this? This is on 20, which is my usual listening thing. Okay, volume's a little low. We might be able to fix that. Let's look at my soundboard. And input. Okay, that's at 100% as it says. Okay, so it looks like I want to move the microphone a bit closer. I think we can manage that. No say the changes. And what we can do is just bring Audacity up again. And we're going to take a crack at bringing the mic a bit closer, see how it goes. Hey. Okay, not the right way, not the right way. I know. Get over there, you. All right. Now we're going to move some stuff around just a little bit. All right, maybe, we're gonna find out. Little bit by little bit, you know? Okay. Alright, we're gonna try. Okay, we've got that going. Here we are. Alright, now we're gonna. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That may be getting. That may be a lot better now. It's going into the red and everything. Alright, so that's that, and we're gonna give that a shot and see how that goes. See how it is. All right, now we're gonna. Oh, look at that! Look at that! That may be getting. That may be a lot better now. It's going into the red and everything. All right, so that's that, and we're gonna give that a shot and see how that goes. Yeah. Okay. That's pretty good then. I am going to then. I am then going to say that it looks like things are going pretty well. I'm glad I got all this set up. I hope you're not bored to tears with it all. Okay, I hope that this does a little bit better, mechanically or electronically or whatever. I mean, of course, you know, this stuff won't do a damn thing for content, but we've got to work on that too. But that being as it is, what I'll do then is, until next time, thanks a lot, troops. See you on the other side. Thank you.